Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Thursday, September 11th, 2008. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures down across the board, so we are looking for a sharp sell-off at the open on Thursday morning, and crude oil and gold are down in the pre-market, so we're looking for weakness on both sides of the border. Still looking for some negative movement in the US dollar. It continues to move higher. And for those of you who are still long the US dollar, this has turned out to be just an amazing trade. For those of you who are playing all the other commodities and everything else, of course, this has been very negative for you. And so we're looking for a breakdown in the US dollar before we see any positive price movement in commodities such as gold, which is down again in the pre-market this morning. And crude oil is down again. So we're probably looking for crude oil to have to come down at least test 100 before it finds support. Looking at the cycles of the moon, we are coming into another full moon this weekend, so I am looking for the markets to change direction next week. Remember, the full moon caught the July lows, it caught the March lows, and not that the full moon has anything to do with catching lows or catching highs. It can just be an influencing factor that helps change the direction of the market. So right now, because the market has been moving lower and the VIX index has been moving higher, we're looking for the full moon to have an effect, causing the VIX to start to break down and the stock markets to start to go up. Now, it might not happen right on cue. We're still projecting higher prices for the VIX right now. And to see the VIX break down, which would indicate that the stock market wants to go higher, we need it to close below 21.25 on a daily basis to confirm that change in trend, and I doubt we're going to see that on Thursday. Looking at some major stocks, Lehman Brothers continued to move lower. 6.25 is their next area of support. I think we're going to hit that on the open on Thursday. Washington Mutual broke down yesterday, lost nearly 30% on the day, and so that's we're seeing continued sign of weakness in the U.S. financial sector. AIG, the big insurance provider, broke down below support yesterday, so 1250 is the next target to the downside for AIG. Looking at some commodity stocks, now they were up yesterday while commodity prices were down. That happens every once in a while. For the most part, none of the major commodity stocks really broke out above the previous day's high or filled any gaps, so that wasn't a really big indication day. It was a reaction day, didn't really give us too much in the way of a positive influence. Looking at Goldcorp there, you can see we didn't break out above the previous day's high. Looking at Petro-Canada, this is certainly an inside day. The whole bar fit inside the previous day's bar, did not break out above the previous day's high. And looking at Potash, similar situation. Yes, it was up on the day, certainly did not take out the previous day's high. So unless you see some action where you're taking out previous day's highs, it's really more of a reaction move than making any new ground. That's what I want to see. I want to see new ground made. I want to see higher highs, and you're not seeing that right now. The TSX had an inside day yesterday, and certainly was it's positive that it held the previous day's low, but certainly didn't break out above the previous day's high. So that's known as an inside day. Similar situation for the NASDAQ, and you can see that the NASDAQ bar is probably about one half the size of the previous day's bar. Didn't really make any major gains yesterday. Looking at the S&P 500, yesterday's activity dwarfed the previous day's bar and made a lower low yesterday. We're not that far away from testing the July lows. You know, we're only a day or two away from being able to test these lows down here, so we might see push down to test the lows. I'm hoping the lows hold. That would be very nice if we could see a major double bottom put in here, but it's certainly possible that we're going to see continued weakness in the U.S. financial sector, and even with the help of the full moon, we're not going to be able to pull ourselves out, but only time will tell. Now, looking at Thursday's market activity, the TSX had a nice big up day yesterday. Like I said, didn't break out above the previous day's high, so we're looking at the midterm chart, our 60-minute midterm chart. I'd get excited if the TSX could start closing above 12,600 on an hourly basis on Thursday. Looking at the right side chart, so this is a more aggressive look, we really want to see the S&P 500 start trading above yesterday's high, and so I'm going to move the marker up to 1244. If you can see the S&P 500 start trading above 1244 on Thursday, then I would buy it as a short-term trader. And looking at the NASDAQ, if the NASDAQ can start trading above 2248 on Thursday, then that would be an indication that this market wants to move higher on a short-term basis, and I would be a buyer. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. It's hard to say have a great day on the morning of September 11th, but do try to have a good day, and we'll be back to talk to you again on Friday morning.